What's up, guys? Welcome to FoundFlix. The Walking Dead aired its seventh season mid-season finale on Sunday, and while this season hasn't been the greatest, the finale at least pointed the story into an interesting, if expected, new direction of all-out war. Now, I'm not here to shit all over the show. I've been a longtime fan, and if you want to hear some more of my thoughts on the state of the show, I'll talk about that at the end of the video. But to me, the most entertaining parts of the season by far have been some moments and scenes that are just plain dumb. No matter if you're a fan or not, it cannot be denied. So, this is not supposed to be me bitching, okay? I promise. It's more about goofing on some undeniably dumb moments the show had this season so far. In episode 2 this season, we were introduced to the kingdom, led by Ezekiel, who has a tiger for a pet. A tiger? What? Call me Shiva, bitches. When they were first revealed, I had a similar reaction to Carol, laughing. Like, what the hell is this supposed to make me think? I'm supposed to be impressed that Ezekiel has a tiger for a pet? I know it's from the comics and everything, but a guy keeping a tiger for a pet in the zombie apocalypse is incredibly dumb, not to mention wasteful. Of course, a tiger is a big, ferocious animal with pointy teeth and claws, but you couldn't even really use it to kill zombies, because chances are it's going to use its teeth to bite a walker and thusly ingest tainted meat, eventually killing the animal. So that's out. All it can do is just sit there next to Ezekiel's throne and be a symbolic accessory of power. But then how much food are they wasting to keep this giant beast alive? On average, a tiger eats 10 to 15 pounds of meat a day. If a person ate a pound of meat a day, and that's still a lot of meat, like 5 average portions, there's a dozen people that could be living per day from the same amount just to keep Shiva alive. It's an insane amount of food being wasted on a big animal that can't even really do anything. This big scene where Mega Douche Spencer approaches Negan hoping to take over is pretty terrible. And as soon as the scene started and Rosita and some others gather around to watch them play pool, I'm like, Rosita, just shoot Negan right now. Do it. Do it now. He's just busy showboating over there, swaying his shoulders around. He's not paying attention. Take the shot! After Spencer gets gutted, Rosita sees this as the perfect time to fire, and we cut to black for the commercial. And when we come back and see what happened, the bullet is perfectly lodged in Negan's bat. It's complete bullshit! Rosita is this badass trained soldier girl, and she misses the shot from like 20 feet away, and literally the only thing between them is the bat. She just has no excuse for missing, and that's why they had to cut to black, because the outcome makes no sense. What really makes it even stupider, moments later Negan tells his soldier girl to kill whoever she wants. She picks Olivia, and even though this girl is on the ground pointing up, perfect headshot. Okay, if you say so, writers. Jesus, it's ridiculous.
Sunday, Sunday, Sunday. See Monster Tractor Maggie with the biggest, baddest tractor action. Cars are gonna get crushed. These guys don't stand a chance. Oh yeah!
This scene wasn't necessarily bad, but Maggie very slowly driving a tractor to help Jesus and Sasha during a walker invasion is very dumb. I mean, what was her plan exactly? To create a distraction, I guess, but she really just runs down a handful of walkers and then crushes that car into oblivion. Meanwhile, Jesus and Sasha are still having to kill a whole bunch of zombies to close the gate. It just seems like there's gotta be a more efficient and less stupid way to create a distraction. I do think the scene, however, would have been awesome if she mowed down like 20 walkers or something, you know, just pure bloody tractor mayhem. But it wasn't like that at all, and it was over pretty quick. Also, couldn't they have, you know, used that car? Now it's just completely destroyed and can't be driven. Wow, thanks so much for helping, Maggie. You did a really good job. Suck my nuts! Just because a moment is dumb doesn't mean I dislike it, and that is definitely the case here. During the final moments of his life, and after just being brained by Lucille, Abraham summons within him the most ridiculous final words of anyone ever. Suck my nuts. I seriously laughed my ass off when he said that because I was so confused, and it straight up did not fit with the very high tension and drama of the scene. You've got all these people afraid for their lives, and during this extremely serious moment, the redhead dude gets hit and is all like, suck my nuts, y'all. Like, what the fuck? Where did that even come from? Was this written by a 12-year-old? It's just silly and definitely dumb. Really, really dumb. But I actually like it because it's so absurd. The show is overly serious and could use a bit of a lighter tone, but this was way out of place. I also did consider if it was me in that situation, would I be able to think of a better final one-liner? I'd like to think so, but I'm sure it's tough to be sassy on the verge of death. Ever wonder what Tara had been up to out on her and Heath's supply run? No, me neither. Well, too bad, because here's a useless extended episode that doesn't really advance the main plot whatsoever. The season has already been moving at a snail's pace, and then we get this bottle episode at the worst possible time. It was just not compelling enough to warrant a whole hour, maybe 15 minutes, or even just have Tara show back up at Alexandria and we see some bits in flashbacks. It did introduce the Oceanside group, but at this point there's just too many other communities, and this just pushed it over the line. These should have been parceled out over the course of the season rather than a new group in every episode. I know they're in a rush to get to all-out war, but maybe be a little more creative in how you move the chess pieces. The rest of the episode is really just filling in the gaps of Tara out on her own, eventually returning to Alexandria. Whoop-de-doo! Now can we get back to the main plot, please? Daryl gets taken by the Saviors and spends most of the season so far looking extra dirty. Like, seriously. I could smell how dirty he is. It's gross. He's being held prisoner in a small concrete room and mildly tortured by the Saviors eating dog food sandwiches. And apparently the showrunners wanted the viewers to also be tortured, and during this episode the light upbeat song Easy Street is played over and over to a maddening degree. Dwight comes and tempts him to join the Saviors, and Daryl just sits there unresponsive. So it's back to the never-ending loop of Easy Street. It's just downright obnoxious. And again, maybe it's to make us feel for Daryl being tortured, because every time that goddamn song would start again, I would lose my mind. I mean, there's gotta be more interesting and certainly less annoying ways to make us appreciate Daryl's situation. So Rick goes on supply runs himself because he's concerned for the Alexandria survivors and wants to make sure they get supplies to Negan. I know it's because he doesn't want any more people to die, but seriously, he's the de facto leader of the group. He shouldn't be out doing monkey work scavenging boats, and it's because he's gone that Spencer and Olivia get killed. But the thing is, there's all these extra people just standing around. What the hell are they doing all day? Just dicking around reading books and drinking lemonade? Waiting for another outdoor pool game? I mean, even if Rick just has to go, maybe send out another team? Increase the odds of finding more stuff? Instead of that, everyone else in the town is just kind of milling around like, oh, is Rick back yet? No? Oh, well, I sure am hungry. Well, guess I better go back to sitting down. What a bunch of useless idiots! I'm just saying, if I was in the same position, I would be helpful and out there doing my part to ensure the survival of the others in my group, instead of literally doing nothing of value whatsoever. I hate to say it, but Negan is a shit villain. I haven't read much of his story in the comics, but to my understanding, his on-screen incarnation isn't exactly what you'd have in mind. I don't think this is entirely JDM's fault, but the way he acts is a bit much, leading backwards and swaggering around, spitting out completely ridiculous lines. Even by the end of the first episode, I was tired of hearing this dude talk, but I think it was around the time of this line,
"Easy peasy lemon squeezy,"
that any menace was completely lost. And I guess I was wrong before about the show being written by a 12-year-old, because apparently they are 4 years old. I know Negan is supposed to be a jokester and undercut the tension of dramatic situations, but it didn't really ever develop beyond that. He has had a few interesting scenes, like those with Carl, and seeing him actually get angry after nearly getting shot, but these have been few and far between. It's like they think Negan can say literally anything and it will be menacing. Even in the mid-season finale, he's like, "Could you kindly pass me a roll, please, Carl?" Smash cut to opening credits. Pass the rolls? You kidding me, dude? I know Olivia and Carl are on edge here, but that line is nowhere near warranting a cut to the credits like it's some huge dramatic moment, but it's just dumb.
"Carl, pass the rolls."
Pass the rolls. So the mammothly successful The Walking Dead is having some issues lately. Ratings have been eroding all season, now reaching the lows of season 3. But don't be too worried, because it's still the biggest show on cable by a mile and won't be going anywhere anytime soon. But what is causing viewers to tune out? The reality is that a show in its 7th season will always struggle to find new ways to surprise us. The thing that seemed to happen this season is that the tricks just aren't working on the audience anymore. We're still seeing the same formula the show has become trapped in, and they're in full effect once again in season 7. The show needs to evolve beyond its formula, and it doesn't seem something that the writers are interested in. A major issue is how beholden they are to adapting directly from the comic lately. They think if they faithfully recreate something on screen that comic book fans will lose their shit. It's become something they are overly reliant on, and to me indicates the showrunners are just out of ideas. But to them, they're like, "We'll never run out of ideas. We can just do stuff straight out of the comic." forever. Obviously, some elements are different, but it seems like they need to create a whole new kind of story dynamic for the show. They need to create a new challenge for our characters. That way it can actually seem new and even contain some surprises for super dedicated comic fans. There's no depth to the human drama, and that is the most important aspect of the show. Also, it has been a struggle getting through these overly long episodes. Seriously, how many episodes really need to be extended? And all that the additional time length adds is to draw out the already thin plot even more. You might be like, quit bitching and stop watching the show. Well, that's all well and good, but they sucked me in after watching for so long. I have no choice but to continue watching and hope for the best. At least we know after setting up the war in the coming 6 episodes, we'll finally get a tiny bit of payoff in the last finale episodes. And I'm sure that whatever finally goes down in the eventual war will be cool enough to draw me back in for next season, because they got me again with their tricks. Another cliffhanger. Anyway, what do you guys think of Walking Dead 7th season so far? Any other dumb moments that you guys found amusing? Let me know down in the comments below. Thanks for watching Found Flicks. See you next time.